This weekend, the arrival of one man threatens everything.
May God forgive you for what you've done.
It's a Catholic issue and it's an issue of science.
Hey, we believe in life.
The business of justice is everybody's business.
The university, by deciding to invite Obama, has said that our prestigious university is more important than our value of human life.
Angels and Obama. Coming Sunday, May 17th to South Bend, Indiana.
It's like a scene from a blockbuster Hollywood movie. Tensions are rising at the University of Notre Dame as the Catholic Church continues to protest President Obama's upcoming commencement address. Now, to date, over 363,000 people have signed a petition against the speech by the president. Protesters have taken to the normally serene Notre Dame campus, and some seniors are now planning to boycott this ceremony. And my guest at this time has been at the forefront of this debate. Randall Terry is the founder of Stop Obama Notre Dame. He was the first person to be arrested for protesting the speech. He joins me live from South Bend, Indiana. Terry, Randall, welcome back.
Sean, good to be with you again, sir.
All right, now, first of all, you were not the originally scheduled guest here tonight.
Yes, that is correct. Dr. Alan Keyes, your longtime friend and mine, is supposed to be with you, and unfortunately, he's sitting behind bars right now.
All right, he's in jail for the second time. You've been arrested in the process of this, as have others. He, as he was being arrested, said this is a betrayal of the faith. Explain.
Well, you saw today that they were walking onto the campus holding an image of Mary with saying, defend her honor. They were praying the rosary. To arrest them for defending life and defending the Blessed Mother while they honor the man who is responsible for deaths around the world now but with his policies is a betrayal of the Catholic faith. Literally, it's not an overstatement. In fact, I think you can barely overstate how grievous this is, because even as we speak, in Africa, in China with forced abortion, in some laboratory where embryos are being created to be destroyed, human life is being snuffed out because of President Obama, and they're honoring him.
Well, but Randall, he had the most radical agenda of anybody, including we debated this whole issue of infanticide when he was a state legislator.
Yes. That's right.
I want to play for our audience. There was a Catholic priest being arrested. We've got it on videotape, but I want to run it for our audience. Take a look at this.
Putting the priest in the coffin.
Get out the case.
Notre Dame is arresting their police. You don't need your people out there break this. Really, we're Catholic priests. Why would you arrest a Catholic priest for trying to stop the killing of a baby? Use your mind. What are you doing that for?
He says, I'm a Catholic priest. Why would you arrest a Catholic priest for stopping the killing of a baby? Use your mind. And this is all happening. What do you think the broader implications of this are in the end for the Catholic faith, for Notre Dame?
There's several things at play here, Sean. I think that Father Jenkins will lose his job as the head of Notre Dame. For me, the bigger soul-searching question is, will the American bishops rise to the level that they are required as potential martyrs? They wear red for a reason. They're supposed to be in the spirit of the apostles. And it has grieved us how at one moment they speak out and then the next minute they run to the shadows. Bishop Darcy, the local bishop, came out great guns saying he was going to boycott this commencement. But where is he now? He has the canonical authority to at least protect us from being arrested. And if just one bishop, just one, would come tomorrow, when Norma McCorvey, who you also know and have had on, when Norma goes on that campus with others to pray tomorrow, if one bishop would come with us, perhaps this whole scandal could be brought to a screeching halt.
Well, and Norma, by the way, she was the name in the Roe v. Wade case, the landmark decision in 1973. All right, but for the sake, though, of where this goes from here, why do you think the university did this, considering his views are the antithesis of that of the Catholic faith? And the argument is that they say, well, you know, he's the president of the United States. How do you respond to that one argument that the president's making, that the president of the university's making?
Well, could you picture Planned Parenthood saying, let's have Benedict, Pope Benedict, come. We'll have him be our speaker at our national event, and we'll give him an honorary degree. It's crazy. So I think that what they were after was prestige. I think that it shows that the Lute University has lost its way. I think that the Catholic Church is in trouble, Sean. Let's be honest. You know it. I know it. We're both Catholics. The fabric, in my opinion, the fabric of Notre Dame's treachery has been woven over decades by Catholic universities, by our priests, and by many of our bishops who refuse to take the strong stand against child killing that John Paul II took and that he required them to take. We are not living out the gospel of life. And by the way, I haven't given up hope of Obama being canceled. I'm asking people who are watching this, get in your car, jump on a plane, be here tomorrow. We've got a ton of things we're doing over the weekend, and people can find out all we're doing at StopObamaNotreDame.com. One long word, StopObamaNotreDame.com. I'm asking people, please, this is a moment for you to make history and help bring the Catholic Church back. Sean, I think it was Bishop Fulton Sheen who said, it will be the laity that saved the church. Our church is in crisis.
It makes no sense to me, Randall. It makes no sense to me that if you have somebody whose views are the antithesis of yours, and I think your analogy was right on, Pope Benedict speaking before Planned Parenthood, it's pretty powerful. We know it would never happen. So why did the leaders of Notre Dame allow this to happen? It's almost unexplainable.
Can you imagine somebody saying, let's have one of the leaders of Germany come in? We don't really like what he did with that Jewish thing, but they built great roads and they gave people hope and they helped rebuild the economy. It's crazy.
All right, we'll be watching this weekend. And as a matter of fact, we'll have a special edition of Hannity. Thank you, Randall. Coming up Sunday night, right after the president gives his speech, 9 o'clock right here on the Fox News Channel. And President Obama has shelled out millions of dollars in stimulus checks. Hey, but don't expect them to jumpstart the economy. An estimated 10,000 checks. Hey, guess who they've gone to? Dead people. We'll explain those details coming up straight ahead. Prime time.